marriage, love and marriage go together like a horse and carriage. This I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other. Love and marriage, love and marriage.
Happy Saturday! We are going on a trip to Italy tonight, and we're going to start with a classic Italian cocktail, the Negroni, and then we're going to move on to a delicious antipasto board, followed by my version of a bolognese pot pie, washed down with a delicious, big, bold Italian Barolo. Stick around, it's going to be a great night. All right, guys, we are going to make our drink, but before we do that, because this wine is such a big wine tonight, I'm actually going to decant it. I was going to just open up the bottle and let it breathe for a while, but I just feel like this is going to be a big guy. So I'm just going to pour this nice and easy into my decanter. Holy Moses. I can already smell how amazing this wine is going to be tonight.
I can already tell that wine is like me, big and fragrant.
Big and fragrant. This is a 2015 Barolo, you guys. It's a Nebbiolo grape, and whew, it is going to pair so well with our lamb and spicy sausage bolognese pot pie that we're going to have tonight. Look at that, is an entire bottle of wine. Just that, right there. That's an entire bottle.
That's it?
That's it. That's all it is.
What a rip.
This was I can tell you guys, I am sorry. Normally I try to bring you bottles of wine that are $10 or less. Tonight, this bottle was $45. When we get to tasting the wine later, I'll give you some other options. If this is not something that you want to go with, there's definitely other options that you can try. In our Negroni, this is the classic cocktail in Italy. Super easy to make, loaded with booze, guys. You know me, I love my drinks. All right, so this is a really easy cocktail to make. Everything is one part. We're gonna do one part of London dry gin. We're going to do one part of Campari, and we are going to do one part of sweet vermouth. All right, I'm just going to stir this up, and then I'm going to shave my orange. You know me, guys. I love my citrus. Love my citrus. Rim. Squeeze. And place. And we have a delicious classic Italian cocktail, the Negroni. Cheers, everybody. Since Big Funky C is not a gin fan, we're gonna make a Negroni for him. Cheers, babe. There you go.
Oh my God, the official drink of America.
I gotta keep my cameraman happy.
Oh, it tastes like freedom, babe.
You all know. My cameraman loves his beer. All right, let's get the show on the road here, okay? I'm gonna just whip some olive oil in the bottom of my cast iron Dutch oven here. And this recipe, it's my recipe, guys, so I can make my own rules. And if you wanna be fancy and use pancetta, you go right on ahead and be fancy and use pancetta. I am using bacon to start. I'm cutting my bacon into my Dutch oven. Brown this bacon.
Seriously, what's that thing called?
It's called a Dutch oven, babe. I know you're 12 years old. Get it out of your system. Whew. This bacon. This bacon smells delish. Oh my gosh. All right, guys, I'm gonna now add my onions, my diced onions. I pre-chopped and diced everything just to save time tonight. You guys don't wanna watch me with a knife.
Can I ask you a question about the Dutch oven?
Yeah.
Is that a tool specifically designed to, just make sure we really get the essence and the fragrance of everything that's cooking up?
Yeah, you wanna make sure that you get the essence and the fragrance of everything with the Dutch oven. Smart ass. We are just sauteing our onions.
Let's get some close-ups here.
We got the bacon. Oh.
So how do you know when it's fully ready for the next
I like to see that the onions are like translucent, that they're turning translucent.
Most people turn translucent when they're in a Dutch oven. I've noticed.
Then I start adding some other things. Y'all, this is just my take on bolognese. What I love about bolognese is it's meaty and it's chunky. There's so many different things in it. I actually am adding mushrooms in mine. It is gonna be amazing. And I actually came up with this recipe. Carl and I went to Virginia to a wine tasting trip to Virginia a couple years ago. And if y'all have not been to Virginia to taste wine and you love wine like I love wine, you need to go to Virginia. They are doing amazing things, especially in Northern Virginia with their Cabernet Francs, their Petit Verdots, Petit Mansang. It's an amazing white grape, white wine. You would love it. So I just, like I said, I came up with this recipe. I'm adding in the carrots now. I'm adding in the celery. Okay, so we have our celery and our carrots, onions, bacon, all nice and sauteing in here. We're gonna add mushrooms next. This is my, I like some extra additions in my bolognese, and because I call this a bolognese pot pie, I just like all these chunky things and additions, and the mushrooms just add a nice earthy flavor and texture with the lamb and the spicy sausage. This is such a great, great dish. All right, guys, I'm adding 4 cloves of garlic now. All right, we are now going to add 1 pound of ground lamb and 1 pound of spicy Italian sausage. All right, now I'm just gonna stamp this out like Sharon Stone in the ice pick in Basic Instinct.
Okay, I don't like that you're taking inspiration from that movie.
And once the meat starts to brown good, I'm gonna add in some wine. Mm. And of course, the wine that I am going to use in this tonight is a Chianti that I found at Aldi for like $5 a bottle. I was like, this is gonna be a perfect cooking wine. Well, I was just telling Carl that because this was my first attempt at this in this Dutch oven, I wanted to do it all and make it a one pot meal not really one pot meal, but like put it all in the same pot. But if you wanted to speed up the process, you could use 2 pans to do your meat separately versus, you know, doing it all in one pot. But
to be fair though, when you do, you know, implement the Dutch oven, you want it to be a surprise and you want it to last a long time.
Actually, no, I don't want it to be a surprise, and I don't want it to last.
The sneak attack! It's the best way to do it.
All right, we are now going to add in a cup of wine. All right, there's a cup of Chianti going in. Now, I want to cook this wine, just kind of let it sit in and marry with all those other flavors and simmer for a little while before I add in my crushed tomatoes and my tomato paste. Then you always want to make sure that you taste what you're cooking with, because surprise, I'm always prepared, y'all. All right, guys, now I'm going to add my crushed tomatoes. I'm adding 6 ounces of tomato paste. So for those of you that are thinking, sometimes I find a recipe and it only calls for like a tablespoon of tomato paste and then I have this whole can. You can get a tube of tomato paste for when you just want to do 1 tablespoon, 2 tablespoons, and then it's easier to use that way. Okay, so now there's a couple things that I like to do with my sauce when I make. So I'm adding in a teaspoon of sugar, just to cut the acid. We still want it to be, obviously it's gonna be acidic, but we don't want it to be that powerful. So just a little bit of sugar. And my go-to, what I love to do, is cinnamon. So I'm just gonna put a nice couple big pinches of cinnamon in my sauce, maybe 3. because I absolutely love what cinnamon does for my pasta sauces. Now I'm going to add a half a cup of Parmesan cheese, and we are going to let this simmer for 30 minutes before we add our heavy cream and our herbs. While this is simmering, we are going to make our antipasto board.
Kim. We are behind the scenes at Saturday Dinners with Ange. This is an up-close, focused look at Barolo decanting. It's from the same people who brought you Watching Grass Grow, with the sequel, Watching Paint Dry.
You guys, if you're cold at all, and you want to warm up, just this Negroni will really take care of all of your needs. I promise you. Woo! What a drink. All right, we are ready. I couldn't decide between an antipasto salad or an antipasto board, so we're gonna combine the two and we're gonna make a salord. Why not, right, babe? So I am going to make a bed of romaine lettuce. I'm just chopping it up. I'm gonna toss it in some Italian dressing. Yep, I'm tossing the Italian dressing in with the romaine lettuce. And this is the bed for our antipasto board. All right, now I'm gonna shave some Asiago cheese on top, because why not, right? Let's just make this bed amazing. Speaking of making beds, are you guys even making your bed anymore?
The answer to that is no.
I try to make it every day. I mean, I would say I'm 85% successful. Wouldn't you say, babe?
The other day I found the bed made with chocolate on it.
Yes, I did. I did. I gave us turn down service. Okay, so I have all of these amazing things that I found that I thought would be amazing on an antipasto board. Antipasto, antipasti, antipasta. I don't know. But I don't even know how I'm going to build this thing. I'm just going to start opening cans and see what happens. So I have Kalamata olives. I have sweet cherry peppers. Oh, I have Spanish queen olives. Oh, I have mild peppercinis. Oh, I have marinated artichoke hearts. Oh, you guys know how much I love artichokes. I have sweet cherry tomatoes.
Those don't need to be in there, I don't think.
Yes, they do. I have mozzarella cheese balls in marinade. I mean, this is like a prerequisite for a anti-something board, right? Like, you gotta have cheese on a board. Wait till you guys see what I found at Aldi. I'm gonna die. It's amazing. I'm so excited. My gosh. Look at this ginormous thing. They call it a panino tray. It has meat and cheese all wrapped up like cheese rolls. Like, it's got cheese on the inside of the meat. Huh. I was like, I don't even have to do anything. I just have to open the package and put it on. This is amazing. I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm just gonna start laying stuff on here. And I may change my mind and move things. Who knows? I don't know. But all I do know is that this is going to be delicious once we get it done. How cool is this, you guys? This is like the thing, the Italian thing, right? Like, you just have all of this. Let's do like a mixture of them over here on this side. I don't know. We're just playing, right? I love to play with my food. It's so much fun. Oh yeah, we'll make them like that. Okay. And then how about, let's see, you guys know I just love color. We should do the mozzarella cheese balls and the cherry tomatoes together in the center, kind of like in a little pile, I think. What do you think, babe?
You don't need the tomatoes.
Yes, we do. They're the star of the show. We can kind of like, yeah, see like that? Oh, that's super cute. Okay. Now, we're going to take some pepperoncinis. Oh, my gosh. This looks so good. So, so good. And lay them. Maybe we can do, like, on either side, we'll kind of match it.
In all seriousness, this is really an area where you really like to get creative, and you're all about the presentation of the food, which I know sounds strange, but it actually makes it taste better.
I think it makes it taste better. That's just my opinion, though. Look at these guys. I've never, ever done these before. Sweet cherry peppers. Let's put a couple of these guys in here. Mmm. They're pretty. Oh, they smell good, too. We'll just kind of... Man, do we have any more red ones? Look, guys, I'm very much a person of balance, and if I have a red one on one side, I have to have a red one on the other. I know. It's, what do we call that, babe? OCD? I don't know what we call it, but I know that I have to have balance. Okay. Oh, gosh, this looks amazing. Now we got some artichokes, and I'm not even going to chop these fellas. I'm just putting them on. Like, let's just, oh, yeah, like that. And then... Oh, this is awesome, babe. I'm going to have this on this side. Like maybe there. And then one more. This is what happens to me, you guys. I get really excited and I forget that there's only two of us here. I'm going to be walking around with this platter in my hand, knocking on my neighbor's doors. Hey, guys, I have some antipasto board to share with you. Would you like some? Okay, guys, now I'm so excited. For the first time ever, I introduce to you Notorious ANG's pickled red onions. And I thought these would be a fabulous, colorful addition to the board, so I'm just going to kind of layer them in these little pockets that we've got some room. I don't know what I'm doing, guys. I'm just making this up as I go. There are no rules. Your kitchen is yours to practice and create and find so many fun things to do. Oh, this looks so beautiful. Oh my gosh, that really turned out nice. You know, I got out the balsamic glaze because I thought what might be pretty is a little bit of glaze on top of the tomato and... Not a lot, just enough. I did this and we have 4 minutes to spare on the bolognese. It's still simmering nice. And we have a beautiful, beautiful antipasto board. Salad board, whatever you want to call it. This would be phenomenal to entertain with. Did you guys see how fast I threw that together? Literally, I just, and done. Oh my gosh, you guys, this smells so good. I am now going to add a half a cup of heavy cream. Move it in slowly. This gives it that nice creamy texture. And I'm going to add in my fresh herbs. I have Italian parsley, I have basil, and I have oregano, all fresh chopped up. About a tablespoon of each. Maybe a little bit more of the parsley and basil than the oregano, but I'm going to stir those in. You guys, this looks absolutely amazing. Okay, guys, so now the most fun part for me is rolling out the puff pastry dough to make my pot pie toppings. So this is a Pepperidge Farm puff pastry sheet that I have thawed out, just rolling it out so that I can get four nice pot pie circles to cover my ramekins. I'm gonna use the little ramekin that I am going to put the bolognese in as my guide. I'm going to turn it upside down and just cut. This is just a nice change of pace from normal noodles. And don't get me wrong, you guys. If you want to talk about someone who loves noodles, you are looking at her. I absolutely love noodles. but this is just a nice, elegant way to serve something with just a little bit of a different spin than your normal way that you do it. All right, so we have four cut out. We actually have more dough there. We'll just put that to the side. And now I'm going to pull my bolognese off the stove. I'm going to put it right in front of me. All right, oh my gosh, you guys, doesn't this look absolutely amazing? Now we're just going to take our puff pastry and lay it right on top, sealing down on the edges. Now I'm gonna put them on a baking sheet and I'm gonna put them in the oven for 15 minutes. All right, guys, we are ready to enjoy our antipasto salord. I don't know, it's my combo. It's my salad board combo. Salord, that's what we're calling it tonight. And I baked my very first loaf of artisan bread this morning. Super excited to dig into this. So I'm going to slice in. We had some friends stop by yesterday and surprise us with amazing olive oils from Italy because they found out that we were going to be doing this episode. So I want to shout out Rick and Kim McGill. Thank you so much for stopping by yesterday and bringing us this amazing treat. We are trying every single one of these olive oils. The dippers I made, I poured the olive oil in and I did some rosemary, some red pepper flakes, some pepper, and a little bit of the balsamic glaze. Delicious. Thank you, Rick and Kim. We love you guys. All right, guys, it is time to pour the wine, and I have been waiting patiently for this all night. This has been decanting now for at least an hour, and I'm only gonna pour just a little bit for both of us. There you go, honey.
Thank you. Uh-huh. Don't mind if I do.
This is a Barolo, so this wine is harvested by hand. It's aged 24 months, so definitely aged longer than Barbaresco. So this is 100% Nebbiolo grape. The differences between Barolo and Barbaresco is that Barbaresco, you don't have to age the wine as long. Barolo, you do. So these are older wines and definitely a very, very big, big wine. This is going to stand up so well to our bolognese pot pie. You don't have to fill them as full as I did. I get a little carried away with myself, you guys. I'm not going to lie. So you can see that clearly I filled them so full that the top's like baked up and but how cute are they though? They're so cute. Little personalized bolognese pot pie. Now if you wanted to do a large one like in a pie plate and just cut the circle to fit that, you can do that. I don't see why not. I just chose to do it this way because the first time I ever made this, it was for the wine dinner that I hosted, and I wanted everyone to have their own personal one. So that's what I decided to do again tonight. It's cute. That's why I bought these little ramekins, and these are going to be D to the lish. Can't wait to dig in.
No one cares if it's running down the side. It all tastes the same.
Nice and golden brown crust. Okay, guys. I have my bolognese pot pie right here, and I'm ready to dig in. Sometimes pasta can be really filling, and what you really want more of is the actual sauce, that meaty, chunky sauce. And so just having this small little piece of pot pie is almost keto, if you ask me. All right, well, we're gonna try to give Poppy some of the antipasto board. Let's see what you think. That's cheese. You're welcome. Cheese and salami. Oh, he seems to like it. Very good. The crust is flaky. The sauce is that spicy Italian sausage is a perfect pairing with the ground lamb. They work so well together. I'm halfway through dinner and I completely forgot to tell you what other wines would pair well with this meal that you could find that may not be as costly as a Barolo. So my picks would be Cabernet, anything that's big with good tannins, I think a Cabernet would be good. I think a Chianti would be really good with this dinner. And I'm going to throw you for a loop here. But for those of you that are like, Ange, we can't stand dry wine. We're a sweet wine drinker. Go get yourself some Lambrusco. Because I think a Lambrusco, even though it is on the sweeter side, would pair phenomenal with this dinner. You've got the spiciness of that Italian sausage. And I just think the richness of this would do very, very well with Lambrusco. So those of you that are sweet wine drinkers, get some Lambrusco. It'll be great. I'm telling you guys, this, you may think that it was labor intensive, but it actually is a very easy way to make your own homemade bolognese. I challenge you to this recipe and let me know how it turned out. Another Saturday Dinners. It's a wrap. Cheers, everyone. Hello, Negroni. It's gonna be a good night, I can tell. Woo! Cheers. Yeah, that is. Woo!
Good job.
That is a. That's
a. Babe, don't forget the bacon.
Huh?
Get the bacon.
Get the bacon. Where's the bacon? Did you get that on camera?
What? Would I ever record without telling you?
How does anybody remember what they
I know.
Did?
It's that drink will not. I tried to tell you. You were like, let's do the national drink of Italy. And I'm like, if you want to get knocked on your ass, that's the first thing you want to do. I drank that with Matt Feltner. Okay? And Matt
Feltner.
Yeah, Feltner was like, this. Yeah, he was like, this is a drink for adults, Carl. I'm like, I'll have a Michelob Ultra.
I never love you more than when you quote Abby Gilmore.
We're going to Italy, but these are from France.
But it is sweet.
No, it is sweet with alcohol. It has sweet alcohol taste too.
It'll sneak up on you. Right? It's a sneaky kind of sweetness.
I feel like it's, you know, already snuck up on you a little, which is good.
Okay, all right. We gotta get serious. Oh, okay, I gotta get my bacon going. You have to remind me, babe, it's very important to remind me that these handles are going to be lethally hot.
Why did they even design those things like that?
Put something
on the handles.
There's probably little thingajobbers you can pop on. Let's check Amazon later. They might be delivered by June. Anyway, what I'm saying is...
No paychecks in 4 weeks. Let's buy more on Amazon.
It's either that or I just keep drinking this Negroni and I won't feel anything, right?
And you know what's interesting about the pot pie pastry trapping the heat in there? It's almost as if the properties of a true Dutch oven, trapping the fragrance and the essence, the flavors.
You need to let the Dutch oven go.